Everything that is his. For the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Deuteronomy mentions something similar. Behold, the heavens and the heavens of heavens is the Lord's. Thy God, the... Oh, by the way, the earth also. With all that therein is. I mean, not just the earth, but everything that is there. Mentioned in Psalm 24, he says, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Oh, and the world and they that dwell therein. That's his too. He goes on to say in Psalms 89:11, the heavens are thine, the earth also is thine. As for the world and the fullness thereof, thou hast founded them. Not only are they his, but he made them. And throughout Scripture, you find a thread of all the things that belong to God. It's really, really great. In Psalm 50, the worlds belong to God. In Psalm 95, the valleys. That's the deep places, he says in Psalm 95:4. The deep places, the valleys and the hills, they belong to God. The sea belongs to God in Psalm 95. In Psalm 50, the animals belong to God. And then he kind of breaks it down. He says in Psalm 50, verse 11, the fowl and the beast belong to God. He says that in Leviticus 27:30, all things on the land belong to God. He says in Psalm 74 that the day and the night belong to God. In Daniel 2:20, he says that wisdom and might belong to God. And he just sums it up in Romans 12, and he says, even vengeance is mine. Now, friends, if we have the wrong perspective, we're going to think that we own what it is that we give. And I have said oftentimes, it's not a matter of how much money we want to give to the Lord, but it's how much of God's money we want to keep for ourselves.